Okay, so the next thing I showed you how to do was to calculate the area of polygons. And we did this first bit where we projected our shapefiles into the state plane system for California, and then we calculated the geometry and we did an integer field. So let's see what we've got here. Let's first look at what our CRS is. So if we go to, let's just I think if we go properties of our, do we get to any? So general, blah, blah, blah. Our CRS is this thing called generated CRS, and it has this stuff. It's user defined, and okay. So it has that CRS, coordinate reference system, and this is all basically the continental, the Albers conic for the lower 48. And what we'd like to do is get this projected into the California state plane, and it was what, Roman numeral 5, I think, for Southern California. So how do we do that? And I think we go to save as, and this is going to be now the LA 1940 join Cal State Plane 5. And now I just need to tell it that that's the coordinate system I want. So can I say, okay, so that's a user defined. Can I say that I want California? Okay. And I don't want Albers equal area. It's, do you remember? It was actually after. It was under Lambert. I don't know if you noticed that in this is, I believe, what we want, but we don't want NAD 27, we want NAD 83 if we have that option. So here it is. And we don't want feet. We want, and I know that's not Roman, but I'm pretty sure what we had in our other one was NAD 83 zone 5 meters. And I believe that that's what this is going to be. And so you may wonder how I got here from here. Well, if we look up, the way that Q has their projected coordinate system stored is based on the projection, which we'll talk about in a couple weeks. And it's a little tricky, but one way to get here would be just to type in California zone. And now it's just giving you the different kind of options for California zones. And the main thing, California Zone 5, NAD 83, I think that's what we want. So I'm going to say okay. There's no batch project here, but now if I add that California's that joined CASP 5 and say open, it should come in under this thing, right? Which it does, because this project properties is set to enable on the fly. And I want to now have the project properties to be in California Zone 5. And so that should, let's see, did that take? Yeah, I want it to be California Zone 5. So I'm going to double click on that and then just say OK. And that's now leveled off this top, which is our indicator that we're now in a, and we're out of that conic, which was flaring everything, and we're into this zone that is best for our locality. So now, if I did the same thing, file, save as, browse, and this is going to be LA 1960 join in the CASP 5. I want to do the same thing, I want to browse, and at this point, unfortunately, it doesn't let me. Yeah, so now I should be able to just pick that from the list because I recently used that. If I just double click on it and say OK, it's now brought that in. If I say OK, it's done, and I should be able to now add that one. And we've got 1940 and 1960. I say OK, open, open. And now I should be able to remove these guys because I don't really need them anymore. And I've got my two layers that are both in California State Plane 5, and they're just different times, and you can see how the boundaries are changing. So now we did all that because we'd like to calculate open the attribute table, and we'd like to calculate area. And so one thing that you'll see is that when we're using the geo database, it had this automatic, okay, so here's our shape area, and but this is what I think this was calculated in that Albers conic, and then when we did the new, once we left and kind of kept on creating these new shape files, we didn't get these two columns appearing at the end that told us the area and the perimeter, because that happens in a geo database, but it doesn't happen automatically in a shape file. So let's go ahead and how do you add the area in Quantum? So did you see what I did there? I subtly clicked on the pencil. So that means that I'm going to start editing. And then I came over here to open the field calculator. And I'm going to create a new field. And I'd like this field to be called, let's say, so who is this? This is 1940. This is going to be the mom. And this is going to be the mom area. And I'm just going to leave this an integer. And then what I'd like to do is, under geometry, say what I'd like to do is calculate the area. So that would calculate the x coordinate of the centroid. That would be the y coordinate of the centroid. Here's the area, perimeter, I think. Or is that the x coordinate of the, I don't know, you guys can play around with it. I can't remember if that is, what does this say? X coordinate of the current feature versus what's this? Returns the x coordinate. You guys could play around this if you want to, but this is returns the area size of the current feature, which is what we want. And if I say OK, then that should kick out the area. And it should be pretty close to this, but probably a little bit different, because I think, again, this area was calculated in the conic, and this one is now calculated. And that's interesting, because I said whole number, integer, right? Did I screw that up? But I thought I asked it to create a new and the whole input, and it automatically decided that it was going to kick out decimals for that calculation. Okay, so let's ponder the situation here. We asked for integers and we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, we got 7 decimal places. Now what's going to be fun is if we save the edits and stop editing and close this table and now open it again, look what happened. We actually only saved the integers. Now, Quantum is a little, this is going to be kind of a quirky thing about Quantum. First, it's going to calculate it as a real and then save it as an integer, if that's what you asked it to save it as. Okay. But it's going to get even more quirky. So let's explore this a little bit further. Let's just say we actually wanted to save the area with decimal places. How would we do that? And if I went in here and I said, okay, so let's make this the M area with as a real number, and I changed this to real, and I went down here and said geometry, area, right? And so now I'm saying in this column for each row, calculate the area of the feature of that row as a real number. And if I say okay, it seems like it's done it, right? If we can expand this guy out and then expand this over and then move this over a little bit, and it's not wanting us to really show it, so let me shove it over here. Shove this over. There it is. So it seems like it's done it here, right? And so now what if we said save, stop editing, and close the table, and open it back up? What we'll find is it actually didn't save any of those decimal places. So what's up with that? Okay, let's just try it again. What if we started toggling the editing session, and we went back over to the field calculator, we say, look, we'd really like to calculate the M area in real numbers, we're willing to give this a second chance. And what if we made the decimal and now it has something to do with this? So precision has to deal with the number of decimal places. So let's say I'm going to calculate that to 6 decimal places. But output field width, I think, has to deal with how many characters you're going to be putting in here. So if I think I say that I'm going to use up six of these spaces for decimal numbers, I should probably, let's just increase how wide this column can be, and I'm going to bump that up to 20. So I can have 14 digits plus six decimal places. And now, if I go to geometry, I'm going to want the area. And if I say OK, it's going to calculate this guy. And so now what do I have? OK. And so if I now save and toggle the edit and close this thing and open it up again, now what do I have? OK, I think, right, so let's make these guys smaller because they don't need to be that. And I'd like to be able to see this table and move this guy out. And so now, if I sort this, we've done okay. It seems like we've saved our numbers. If I sort this, the biggest one, I've kept, because this is one, two, three, four. Hi, they're coming. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and then six decimal places. So it looks like we've done that. Okay, and that may, and I'm going to close that, and let's see why that mattered in a second.